In Kaduna, a bit of normalcy has returned to the state after the government partially lifted a 24-hour curfew. Residents are now free to move around from 5 a.m. to 6 p.m. and President Muhammad Buhari has also been in the state to meet with stakeholders, religious and traditional rulers. Our crew has been in the state to monitor the president's visit and see how residents are reacting to government's efforts to stop the killings.
The calm after the storm. Residents of Kaduna State are now free to move around. But things have not always been like this in the past 2 weeks. The state government had at two different occasions imposed a 24-hour curfew in Kaduna Metropolis and four other communities after more than 55 people, including a traditional ruler, were killed in the state. The government has now relaxed that curfew, allowing residents in the affected communities to move around between 5 a.m. and 6 p.m. With activities slowly returning back to normal, one resident is positive things will change for the better.
Things have returned back to normal. People are rushing to buy food in large quantities, though I don't know, maybe because they feel maybe in case. But I believe that everybody is even smiling.
Some residents are, however, less optimistic.
Kaduna has been a state that is a very fragile state when it comes to issue of conflicts. On the part of government, I think the main issue has not been tackled as far as I'm concerned, because I don't see reason why Kaduna should be coming back to this same situation that we've gone past way back. And there are a lot of development that intends to come into the state, but with this, I'm afraid they've really drawn the state backward.
You cannot run away without fear, because even as we are, you can see the number of vehicles that used to move around are not up to that number. So I want to believe there's that fear. I know the curfew is still going on by 5. So by 4 o'clock, you see people will start moving down back to their houses. So I want to tell you that fear is still there, except the situation is fully brought under control.
To provide more assurance, President Muhammad Buhari has been in the state to meet with the stakeholders, traditional rulers and religious leaders. At this meeting, President Buhari assures that his government will ensure those responsible for the killings are brought to justice.
I am appealing to the Nigerian police and the judiciary. The Nigerian police are in the front line of securing communities. The judiciary will just sit there unless investigations are credible and prosecution rapidly done, there is nothing they can do. From now onwards, the Nigerian police, you better watch it. I'm going to watch you closer.
Kaduna State Governor Nasir El-Rufai also uses the opportunity to reassure his commitment to the security of lives and properties.
By boosting security assets, improving the pace of prosecutions, and strengthening the justice delivery system, the Kaduna State Government will surely be making our state safer. But our communities have to enlist in the coalition for peace. Beyond boots on the ground, a phalanx of security agents and expeditious delivery of justice, the ultimate guarantee of peaceful coexistence is the willingness of individuals and our communities to exercise mutual tolerance and live in peace.
The police have now arrested 93 suspects in connection with the killing. 43 of the arrested suspects are expected to be charged to court immediately, while the other 50 are still under investigation. Adeshewa Odushaga, TV360, Nigeria.